Now, companies are also looking to buy thermal scanners, which are becoming crucial as a first line of defense against the virus. But a doctor tells us there are limitations to this strategy. Cheryl Goh reports.
Thermal scanners like these are fast becoming part of everyday life. They're already deployed at all air, land and sea checkpoints as a first screening measure to detect any potential cases. And more companies are looking to buy them as an additional safeguard. One company CNA spoke to says they've already sold out.
And unfortunately, it's caught us at a pretty wrong time because we just launched a new scanner. So we just did a first run and it was very, very limited stock. And right now we are doing our second run, which hopefully we can catch up with the demand.
And these devices don't come cheap, costing between $20,000 and $70,000. OmniSense adds that they don't expect the prices of their thermal scanners to go up, even with the surge in demand, and it wouldn't be right for anyone to profiteer from an unfortunate situation. Instead, they will focus on driving up their production volume to ensure sufficient supply. Newer models are also able to detect mild fevers, which are below 38 degrees Celsius. But one doctor notes even thermal scanners are not 100% foolproof. Case in point, Singapore's first novel coronavirus patient didn't have a fever when he first arrived.
People will have fevers that they can also mitigate with the use of antipyretics, for example, and that at that point in time when they pass through, they may not be able to be picked up by the thermal scanner. But having said that, it is a complementary tool because when you are assessing large volumes of people and mass numbers, it's difficult to go and after each and every individual.
Besides fever, Dr. Kurup adds a more visible telltale sign of the virus is breathlessness, and authorities may need to manually observe and query individuals with the symptom to enhance the screening process.